Okay, hello everybody. Welcome to this week's live mapping session. I'm Ralf Schemann of Pro Fantasy Software, and tonight I'm gonna show you a bit of dungeon floor plan work with this year's black and white inked dungeon style from the Cartographer's Annual. We've done a few dungeons already in previous sessions, so this time I want to show you a few extra things, a little more advanced stuff, but which comes up fairly often. Things like importing an existing PNG into a map to trace over it, and editing and creating your own drawing tools. And perhaps some other things will come up along the way. So let's get started with the dungeon. Or let's take a quick view through the interface again. We've still got a few new people joining us regularly. So let's take a look what I've got here on screen. I've got the drawing area with the example map showing at the moment. That's the where the action is going to take place. To the left of that, at the moment empty, is the symbol catalog window. And to the left of that are the standard drawing toolbars with editing options and stuff like that. Above the drawing area is the catalog toolbar, which lets you load different symbol catalogs during creating a map. And above that is the file toolbar, where you can save and open files, and you can switch between different menus from the different add-ons. Above that is the properties bar, where current drawing properties are shown, like the color you've currently selected, the sheet and the layer, fill styles. And to the left of that, the coordinate tracker, which tells you at which where your mouse pointer is on the map. If I activate the window, you can see that it changes as I move the mouse pointer around. To the right of the drawing area are the CAD toolbars, which with all the standard or basic CAD drawing tools, like drawing lines and shapes, ordering entities in the map, and the zoom tools up on top. Everything's also available through the menus on top. And from there, I'm now going to start a new map by going to the file toolbar and click the new map icon. I'm not going to save this map. And this opens up the new drawing wizard, the tool that lets you choose what map type and style you want to start drawing. First up is the map type. And as I said, I'm going to use a dungeon style for this live mapping session. So we're going to select the dungeons and click Next. Then we've got lots of different styles available. Everything down here that starts with CC3 and DD3 is included with Dungeon Designer 3 and the base program. Down here are the styles from the symbol sets 2 and 4. And up here all the various dungeon styles from the Cartographer's Annual, which we've created over the years. And I'm going to go for the inked dungeon style that came with this year's annual. So I'm going to click Next again, and then I can set up my drawing area, how large it's going to be. This will be in feet for a dungeon map. Unless you've chosen the metric template, then it will be in meters. And I'm going to choose something not too large, because that's, otherwise it's going to be hard to see things and to fill the map in a session like this. So we're going to go with 250 by 200 feet. I can put in a map title and copyright notice in here. Let me show you. So let's give our map a map title, and let's call it the Crypt. And then I choose where I want this to place this title. I'm going to go with top left and choose the map title here. And this will mean the map creation will place this title in the top left of the map. And that's enough for the setup here at this moment. So I'm just going to click Finish. and see the title I saved will be my default file name, which suits me fine. I just want to save it in a different place, and the current stream folder, and save this. And there you can see the title is up here, the map border is showing, and we can start creating our map. As I said, for this session, I want to show you how to trace over an existing map. My idea is I want to create a crypt below a church or cathedral with this map style. And for that purpose, I've looked through the internet and prepared a map or a bitmap file of an existing crypt. So I'm just gonna choose draw from the menu, and I want to insert a file. But actually, what I want to do first for that, I want to do set up a custom sheet for the bitmap, so I can easily hide and show that during the drawing. So I'm going to do a complete fresh one, and I'm just going to do add a new sheet bitmap. Well, that's all okay. And I'm also going to change the layer, because I'm going to put that on the temporary layer, because I'm going to remove that bitmap at the end of creating the map again. So now we can go to draw and insert file. And here you see this is the bitmap I've prepared, cropped already. So I'm just going to open this. And for this drawing here, the file path is not so important, because I'm going to delete that later. But if you want to keep the bitmap in the map and move it around and give it to other people, perhaps, you should always store the file's path relative to the current drawing. If you choose the absolute path, other people will not be able to see it in the map, because on their computer, probably the path is going to be different. So I'm going to do that and click one corner here and just make the image large. I'm going to show you how to scale this to the proper size in a minute. Just place it in here so I can see it. There's my imported bitmap. Now you can see I've got a scale bar in the image here that shows me the size of the thing in meters. I'm not concerned about doing an exact sized copy, so I'm just going to assume the 40 meters in here should be about 120 feet in the map I'm drawing. So I'm going to check how my current scale of the image is. For that, I'm going to go to Info and choose Distance. Click here, and then to the right here, and the distance is 110 feet at the moment. So I want to make this a little bit larger to have this at 120 feet. For this, I'm going to go over to the editing tools, and this is the scale icon or scale command, but I'm not going to use the standard one, because that is for scaling visually, moving the stuff around by eye and hand, and I want to scale this numerically. For this, I'm going to right-click the button and choose non-visual scale. Now I'm going to select the bitmap by clicking on the edge, press D for do it, and as you can see on the cursor and the command line, this it now prompts me for my scale factor, what factor should the image be scaled? And the neat thing is we don't need to calculate that. I can simply say I want my which bitten the 120 divided by the 110 it currently is, and then press return and choose the scale center. I think this is a good point up here, and this is now scaled, so that, let us check, this is, no, actually, it's a bit, that's the, I picked a point a bit to the right of the scale bar, And there you can see it's 120 feet now. This is good enough for my purposes. Okay, so we can start drawing our map area now. It's a pretty complicated shape and probably not well suited to our typical tools of the room and corridor connections, so we're going to do this a little bit differently. First off, I'm going to add a sheet effect to the bitmap sheet because I wanted to make this transparent so I can see the stuff I'm drawing through the bitmap. So I'm just going to click Add, choose a transparency, and I just want to make this 20% opaque. It's good enough to see the shape and everything, and you'll see in a second that I can see all my rooms and walls pretty neatly through this bitmap now. Okay, what I'm going to start with, I'm going to draw a big room to give for the general shape of the church, of the crypt. I'm going to choose the rectangular room shape. I'm going to keep these solid fills. Color white for the background is fine. Color very dark gray for the wall is fine as well. I'm just going to click OK. Going to choose this as my leftmost point, draw the map all the way up to here, of the room, and let me show you. I'm going to change the coordinate tracker to the at symbol here. You can change this by clicking on it and cycle through different ways to display the coordinates. What I was using before is the absolute coordinate points, and what I was interested in is the relative coordinates. This means how far away I am from the latest picked point. So I can see now this will be 70 feet downwards. Same x coordinate as this one, and 70 down, 70 feet down. Well, that's fine. Okay, let's refresh the screen. And this is our basic layout. Now how to go from here. I now want to edit this shape and put in all the extra bits and pieces and little nooks and crannies. And for that, I do need an editing function. But if I check, my room can only draw rooms, I can't edit existing rooms, so I'm gonna need a drawing tool for that. Unfortunately, this style, because it's a fairly basic annual style, doesn't have its own room drawing tool, but I'm gonna create one. So, see, these are the available drawing tools for the style, and I'm gonna take one which is fairly similar to what I want. I'm gonna click Advanced and go for the interior walls here, and gonna change that into my room drawing tool. For that, I'm just gonna click New. This will basically make a copy of the existing one, and I'm gonna just name this room Default. And let's check the properties. Let's actually change. Start with the outline, because that shows the walls, and this is where we want them already. We've got walls on the walls layer, the wall sheet. The size is 1 foot, which is the same as I use for the room draw, the room command. So this is fine. But for the normal properties, we do need the setup for the floor instead of a walls outline, so I'm gonna put it on the floor sheet, and I'm gonna choose the layer background floor 1. 0 width is fine, and fill style solid is good, color white, color 15 as well. The rest is fine. So I've got a room drawing tool now, which I can now use by clicking OK. I'm going to save the settings. And now you can see it says first point E for edit. So I can edit my existing room shape. It recognizes the rectangle I've drawn as a room because it's set up with the same properties. The floor is on the same sheet and layer as well as the walls. So CC3 Plus knows that this is supposed to be a room. So, and I'm going to start out by drawing this little extra side room here at the top. And I'm going to press E, choose the point I'm going to start my edit. This is the corner node here. And now I can draw the new shape. Don't need to match the existing one exactly. I'm going to stick with the grid points instead. Makes it a bit easier. Okay, this is the new shape. And now I need to right click to finish it and connect it to the next corner. And because this is just a line, no corners in between, I go all the way up here to the right. And there's my extra side room. Gonna do the same down here to this side room. Gonna start from the other side. Zoom in a bit. Go. Endpoint is up here. So we've got the next side room ready. Then we're going to go down here. Do the same at this side. Let's make this a little bit further apart. How far should we go? This looks good. There we go. And the good thing with the drawing tool, if you place a wrong point, you can always hit the delete key to go back to the previous note. There we go. This is going to be our stairs to the upper level. Again, wrong note. And the right click to finish. Okay, next thing I want to do, the big, larger part here, and I want to show you a little bit extra here. Let's do the general shape of this area first. Again, open up the room default tool and edit the existing shape. I'm going to skip this part here because I want to do something special with that. Let me see that I'm doing this probably. Yeah, looking good. And the edit. Here's my end of the crypt. And what I was thinking is I want to create a half or semicircle end here for this area, because I wanted to show you how to add a semicircular extension to an existing room. For that, it's easiest if we draw a guiding entity first. For that, I'm gonna change my fill style to hollow. Just click the circle. This is my midpoint here, and this is gonna be my semicircular extension of the room. Now I can go in and choose my room tool again, edit the existing wall, and now I can use the trace function, press T to trace, of the tool to trace the semicircle, the circle, all the way down here. There's my trace ends. Right click and pick the end node for the edit. And here's my semicircular extension of the room. Now I'm just going to erase the existing circle. And that was quickly and easily done. We can do the same with something a little more complicated. Let's take a look. I've got these extensions here from the side. And for that, I'm going to draw these first, because they are these angled directions. This is going to be hard to draw right here in the correct location from the start. So instead, I'm going to draw it off to the side first. Let's make it 5 feet wide. And then I'm going to choose the arc tool to put the semicircular end cap on the shape. Now, because I wanted to trace it and it needs to be one entity, so I'm going to make this into a path with the line to path tool. Right click, do it. And now I can move this piece to the correct location. I can hold down shift to rotate it. This looks good. Place it here. And what I'm now going to do, I'm going to mirror this. So I've got the same piece here at the other side. Now I've got to remove my cat from in front of the screen first. There you go. And now we're going to mirror this. Mirrored copy. Select this. D for do it. Choose the mirror line. It's just the center line of our floor plan. And there's our second entity down here. Now I'm going to go back to the drawing tool and edit this. What I'm going to do now, I want to start the edit, the trace exactly. Oh, no, don't. We can just simply press T, start the trace down here. Actually, for this, I'm going to turn off the snap so I can choose the start point more precisely, all the way to the end. And right click to finish. Do the same down here. Edit. Trace the entity all the way around to the end. Right click, finish. And so that way you have complicated sections of the wall which you can easily add with the room drawing tool. What we now need to do is remove the help entities we've placed there. There we go. Let's take a quick look whether we've got any questions so far. And if we do, I'm going to continue with a few more edits and the interior walls for the floor plan. Oh, Sue had a bit of a problem. It's a bit of a crash, but she seems to be fine again. So send in your questions if you have any, but none so far. That's fine. I can just continue creating my map. Next up, I want to add some of the alcoves, niches, or however you want to call them, at the edge of the walls of the room. For that, I'm just gonna use my drawing tool again. Edit the existing. Now I need to turn on snap again. Just draw these shapes here. Oops. Delete is your friend. Finish. Yes, on this side. Same down here. See, you can use the crosshairs cursor to nicely see that you're putting them in at the same location. third one, and the fourth one. We've got this bit of an extra nook here. We'll just add this. And opposite of the entrance here is another alcove. And up here, oh, there was a click at the wrong time. One and oh, it was too early. There we go. And a little extra nook in the center. Looking good. There's a little extra alcove up here. So I'm gonna that in here. We've changed our layout a little bit at this section of the map, but that's fine for our, it's our own map after all. So that's looking pretty good for our general layout and shape. Okay, Sue has a question. If you move a node tool on a wall node, will it also move the corresponding floor? So she means if I pick the node edit here and move this node, then you'll see that it just actually, okay, this is now I'm surprised myself, but because this used to not work, but I think with our, just remember with one of our latest updates, we have actually now introduced this function that it does work now. So yes, you can do that. Oh, that's cool. I didn't know that myself. Excellent. Okay, and Hans König would like to see the info tool again. So very useful. Little command which I use all the time. It's just from the info menu. The list is the actual name of the command. If you do that and select an entity like the wall here, now you actually now select both the wall and the floor, but that's fine. Press D for do it. It will list all the information about the entity. In the case here of the walls, you've got a lot of information because it lists all the nodes, all the corners of the polygon. But very importantly, it shows you which sheet the entity is on, the wall sheet, which layer it is on, background floor one. The color, white, this is for the floor. And line style, fill style, and so on. And if you scroll down, you'll see this is the second entity, which is on the is black and on the walls layer. So it's the black walls. And what I notice here, this is actually something wrong. The floor should not be on the wall sheet. This must have happened with our little accident that we had with the walls vanishing. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to move this to the correct sheet. For that, I have the very handy move to sheet command, which is on the sheets icon, move to sheet. And I'm going to select this by color, and I'm going to select the color 15, which is white. Oop, this is also selects the whole black map background, which is obviously also white. So what we're going to do, we're going to do not the background. So this is just the floor, D for do it, and this should go on the floor sheet. Better. Let's hide the bitmap for a moment. So you can also see that we have a drop shadow on the wall. The sheet effects are not very strong on this dungeon style, but they do have an important function for the look of the map. Okay, so we're gonna show the bitmap sheet again. Especially if you don't know where stuff is located or what the properties of an entity are, the list command is your friend. There's more. The other one I used for me is the distance command, which lets you just measure the point between the distance between two points. Say I want to know how far away these two corners here are. Front click, second click, same distance is exactly 10 feet. So let's continue with the interior walls, basically the big pillars holding up the roof and all the cathedral above. For that we have our own drawing tool and the interior walls we've used before. And I wanted to show you, no, actually let's just draw one to start with. Okay, let's just, come on, there we go. So interior walls, and if I wanted to change something like have the drawing tool with a wider wall, I could go in and click advanced here on the basic tool. That's your key to editing and changing drawing tools. Select the drawing tool in here, and from the properties you could say that from the outline, which is actually the walls in this tool, I wanted to have the walls wider, or say want narrow walls, 0.5. You can see in the preview already that these changes get applied immediately. But I'm going to take it back to the default because it's the same as the standard wall width I have for the map. What you can, it does look narrower than the outer walls. But that's because they are half hidden behind the wall outline that's hiding the stuff. I can show you if I hide the wall's outline sheet. See, they have the same width. And we're going to add a wall's outline to the outer walls in a little bit, and then they'll be all the same width like this here. Okay, so we've drawn this bit of interior walls, and because all the other ones here are pretty much the same, or the next ones at least, I don't want to draw each of them separately, so I'm going to use the trusty copy command. Copy, select what I want to copy, D for do it, select point, destination, and then we can use the mirrored copies command to take all these and copy them down here. So you can see my center line wasn't quite the total center from the map. So I can all just simply move these down a little bit to align with this alcove on the left. Okay, so I've got a few more of these things to draw. Right. It's a basic cross shape. And again, we're going to take this and copy it And here I can actually just copy it because it's symmetrical. You can just copy it down here. This should be a bit, little bit further to the right. What's the wrong insertion point there? And then a bit here. Not too worried about matching the original precisely. We're taking our liberties with that anyway. For this, again, I'm going to use the mirrored copy command. It's easier than simply redrawing that and moving it in the correct place. And then we just need the shapes in the middle. A little bit larger. One up here. One here. One here. Now I'm gonna copy this one. One down here. Oh, actually, this is, I think, a bit larger than the one. No, it looks correct. And this one down here. And there's basically my walls layout. Let's hide the bitmap. And there's my cathedral crypt. Looking pretty nice, but it's just the basic layout, so we're gonna need to pretty this up a little bit. The first thing I want to do is add some wall textures around, or earth textures, or stone textures around the outer walls. And for that we have our drawing tools in this style down here, outline brick, outline earth. I'm gonna go with hatch. I'm gonna go with the brick here. And this aligns, the hatch style aligns with the first edge we are selecting or drawing for this. So let's make sure we draw a horizontal line first so we don't have a strangely angled brick hatch. Well, this I'm gonna start here. And then I'm going to trace the existing outline. Just press T. And follow all the outline around back here. And then I need to go along the outside of the map. Because I'm drawing a shape surrounding the existing walls. Otherwise, we just fill the interior completely. It's just not what we want to do. That's the wrong note. And there's our brick outline around the vaults. The hatch styles can sometimes leave artifacts in these little nooks because the calculation gets it wrong. See, the basically the brick line crosses this the arrow which should not be. The easiest way to fix this is simply unlock groups. That's the locked button down here. Because all the hatch styles, which are all individual entities drawn, but all grouped together. And if you want to delete something out of that group, we need to unlock the group first. Then choose Erase, select the P pieces. And D for do it, C, and we've got it removed another little bit here. And two more lines here. See, it's gonna remove little, some few pieces outside, but this is hardly noticeable since the fill is pretty irregular anyway. So, of course, now the interior walls should have a similar fill. So what we can do is we can use our change like draw tool again. Use our change like draw tool command again. I'm going to save the map. I'm going to right click here, change properties for the change like draw tool. The draw tool I want to select is the outline brick here. And now I want to select all the entities. I want to apply this, but not the walls. So I'm going to select when not the layer walls. Where's my walls layer? Down here. See, the black outline is unselected. D for do it. And there's my brick fill. See, if I use the change like draw tool like that, it will align the fill to the side of the polygon that I've drawn first, which it finds first when checking it. And this means some of them will have a little bit of different alignment, but I think this looks quite good on this one here. Very cool. So the next thing I want to do is add a little bit of background, earth background around that, because I find the edge still a little bit too regular. See whether we've got fill for that. Of course we have. We have the wall background 1 and wall background 2. I don't know which one's better. They're just a little bit different to give some variation. So I'm just going to choose the wall background 2. See, you can always see the current sheet and the stuff is gets placed on up here. So it's going to go on the wall's background sheet, which is below the floors. So I can just simply draw this all around and not bother following the outline precisely. Finish and see it's nicely in the background. I could add a floor fill at this point, like tiles or so, but I think the map's gonna get too busy if I do that, so it looks nice with the white background. And I'll leave it at like this. What I want to do is move the title. I find it a bit too small. In here, I can just move, scale, rotate with the command, select the title, press D, origin point, and move it or scale it. Let's scale it up a bit. That looks much better for a title. And that's looking nice already. Now let's see whether we can add a few symbols. For example, I wanted to add stairs up here. For that, I'm gonna load up the stairs catalog. This is a 5-foot wide corridor. It's going up. I think it should be a bit wider and have the arrows here. What I can do, I can also use drawing tools for this. I think we have stairs drawing tools? No, I don't. Oh, mistaken. That's too bad, but no problem. We're just going to use this one here. You can just nicely place this in here. And it gets placed behind the walls and the wall outline. so it fits in there very nicely. Let's add a door. 5 foot door here. Use the arrow keys to align this. So just add a door. And then just the only other thing I'm going to do is I'm going to add an altar here. And I could more actually could add a few statues here in the alcoves. This is Christchurch Cathedral in Dublin, and you'll if you check the Wikipedia article, you'll find where I've got the floor plan from, and it's got some nice memorials down there, so putting the statues in here is quite fitting. Okay, now the only thing I want to add is some labels to the map and show you some of the way these are done in this, or can be done in this style. Let's have a look. We've got the cartouches in here because we have the number label symbols in here. These are nice on the black background, so I can click this. This is obviously way too large. I'm gonna align that to a good size. This looks good. And as you place the symbol, it asks you for the number it should put into the circle. So I leave the 1 on this one, say, and then I can put a 2 in here, a 3 in here, 4, Five, 6, and 7, okay, and there's something going wrong with that symbol. Okay, it's got the 1 showing in there. That's something new. I really didn't happen to me before. Got a cat here again, which is craving attention. So I'm gonna check the symbol manager and see whether we can fix this. I'm gonna edit the symbol reference. Oop, this was a misclick. See again. Edit. And let's see what the properties info list. Oh, actually, I've got the text in there and the text attribute, which is, of course, wrong. It should only be the text attribute. So I'm going to erase by entity type 2D text. Do it. Save it. And the neat thing is, if I edit the texts, the symbol reference from the symbol manager, it updates all the symbol reference in the map, and you see the extra 1 in the symbol is gone everywhere. Aza is the name of the cat. I guess she's going to be the star of this this video. All right. Other thing is, let's put in a scale bar. Got one in here. I'm going to set this back to normal. So this is going to be a 100-foot scale bar, which is a bit large. So let's make this half size. Yeah, it's a good size. And labeled it with 50. So it's a 50 feet. And put in a comp Pisrose. Actually, this is the correct orientation of the... let's see, did I have that on the bitmap? I think so. Yep, you can see the north bar is here on the left, and this is actually aligned on correctly for Christian Church on the east-west axis. And so this is pointing north. And there we are. That's our neat little cathedral crypt created from an existing PNG file, which is of course useful not only for floor plans, for all kinds of overland maps, your old hand-drawn materials which you want to recreate. And I can now go in and erase this. So I can say erase by layer. I put it on the temporary layer. Okay, do it. And there's our layout. Quick and easy. And even with setting up new tools and not really a lot of work. Hope you enjoyed today's session. The video will be archived on YouTube as usual. So if you want to check out material in there later, you can always go back there and see whether you find anything useful in the ongoing video. Let me check any more questions. It's not looking like that. Everybody just loves the cat. So thank you, Aza, for taking care of that. And have a nice evening and see you again next week. Bye-bye.